Artemis is known as the goddess of the hunt and is one of the most respected of all the ancient Greek deities. It is thought that her name, and even the goddess herself, may even be pre-Greek. She was the daughter of Zeus, and the titaness Leto. And she has a twin brother, the god Apollo. Artemis' mother Leto was hounded throughout her pregnancy by the jealous goddess Hera but eventually found refuge on the floating island of Delos. There she gave birth to Artemis, who assisted her mother as midwife with the birth of her younger twin brother Apollo. Just a tiny break here. I want to give you a little reminder. While we are filming this video, we only have 264 subscribers and 95% of the views are coming from non-subscribers. If you really enjoy our videos, please subscribe to our channel and help us to reach more people, if you think these content deserves that. Okay. Let's continue with the Artemis. In ancient art, Artemis was usually depicted as a girl or young maiden with a hunting bow and quiver of arrows. She was the patron and protector of young girls, and was believed to bring disease upon women and relieve them of it. Artemis was worshipped as one of the primary goddesses of childbirth and midwifery along with Eileithyia. Much like Athena and Hestia, Artemis preferred to remain a maiden and is sworn never to marry. Even though Plato says that the name, Artemis, is related to her virginity and the ancient Greek word for unharmed, or pure, we now know that its origin is undoubtedly different and possibly even Persian. However, scholars can't agree over its original meaning. There are several myths about Artemis and they all have some different versions. In this video, we are going to tell only the most famous versions of most famous stories. The myth of Artemis and Orion is a sad love story between Artemis, goddess of the moon and the hunt, and Orion, a hunter who is the son of Poseidon. Artemis has vowed to remain a virgin and stay unmarried forever. Orion is chasing a group of nymphs and being creepy. Before he can catch them, Artemis saves the nymphs by turning them into stars in the sky. Afterward, Artemis and Orion meet. Through their shared love of hunting, they become good friends. Apollo, god of the sun and Artemis' brother, does not approve of this friendship, because he thinks that Artemis will fall in love with Orion and marry him despite her vows of maidenhood. So, he hatches a plan to end their friendship once and for all. He knows that Orion, being the son of the god of the seas, has the power to walk in water. One day, while Orion is walking out in the sea, Apollo invites Artemis to the beach. He brags about his marksmanship, and then dares her to prove her hunting ability by hitting a black speck far out at sea, which he knows is Orion. Artemis immediately takes out her bow and arrow and shoots the speck, which disappears. Then, however, the waves carry Orion's body to the shore, in front of Artemis. She turns to her brother and weeps, knowing she has fallen for his horrible scheme to kill Orion. She puts his body in the skies, among the stars. To this day he remains there, with his dog Sirius following him and the nymphs ahead of him. In Greek mythology, Callisto was a nymph, or the daughter of King Lycaon. The myth varies in such details. She was one of the followers of Artemis, who attracted Zeus. According to some writers, Zeus transformed himself into the figure of Artemis to lure Callisto and rape her. She became pregnant, and when this was eventually discovered, she was expelled from Artemis's group, after which a furious Hera, the wife of Zeus, transformed her into a bear. Later, just as she was about to be killed by her son when he was hunting, she was set among the stars as Ursa Major, the great bear. She was the bear mother of the Arcadians, through her son Arcas by Zeus. Iphigenia was the daughter of Agamemnon and Clytemnestra in Greek mythology. While the Greek army was preparing to set sail for Troy during the Trojan War, Agamemnon caused the anger of the goddess Artemis, because he killed a sacred deer. So, she decided to stop all winds, and the ships would not be able to sail. The seer Calchas realized what the problem was, and informed Agamemnon that to appease the goddess, Agamemnon had to sacrifice Iphigenia to her. Reluctant at first, Agamemnon was forced to agree in the end. He lied to his daughter and his wife by saying that Iphigenia was to marry Achilles before they left. The mother and daughter happily went to the port of Aulis, only to find out the horrible truth. Achilles, unaware that his name was used in a lie, tried to prevent the sacrifice, but Iphigenia utterly decided to sacrifice herself in honor and of her own volition. The most popular version of what happened afterwards is that at the moment of the sacrifice, the goddess Artemis substituted Iphigenia for a deer, but Calchas, who was the only witness, remained silent. Iphigenia was then brought by Artemis to the city of Tauris, where she became the goddess priestess. Respecting some other divinities, or attributes of divinities, which were likewise regarded as identical with Artemis in Greece, see Britomartis, Dictyna, and Eleithyia. The Romans identified their goddess Diana with the Greek Artemis, and at a comparatively early time they transferred to their own goddess all the peculiar features of the Greek Artemis. The worship of Artemis was universal in all Greece, in Delos, Crete, Sicily, and southern Italy, but more especially in Arcadia and the whole of the Peloponnesus. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the thumbs up, subscribe our channel and click on that bell. It really does help to support our channel. Don't miss the other adventures of the Olympians, and of course every kind of mythology.